When I was a child, I used to lay in bed late at night, staring at the ceiling, listening to my father scream. Scream at my mother, scream at yet another failed masterpiece. Finally, just scream out into the darkness. It became my lullaby. And even when they took me away, the screams followed. I was once told that insanity runs in my family. It's time to make it stop.
Oh, it reeks in here.
I swear, that dog doesn't shut up! How the hell did you get out? Go on, get out of here! Before I find a way to keep you in there for good.
I wonder when was the last time this place saw sunlight. What's wrong with this thing?
Hey there. Oh, come on, don't be afraid. It won't bite. Here, try for yourself. You know what? I have an idea. Go get your crayons.
Oh, Princess, don't sneak up on me like that. Especially when I'm working. So, what do you think? Oh, you like it? Well, that makes one of us.
Are you out of your mind?
What? You said there was gonna be a party. I just started a bit early. What? You said there was gonna be a party. I just started a bit early. Whoops.
This one's gonna be perfect. It has to be. I'm gonna prove you wrong, all of you.
What? Not now, Princess. Go play with your dollies or your crayons. Daddy's very busy.
Thank you. too. Well, that makes it all better, doesn't it? It'll just magically unbreak because you didn't mean to. Go on, get out of here. Go to your room and break shit in there. Just take all your toys and smash them one by one. And keep at it. Maybe you'll finally get good at something.
You're not thinking straight.
You're right. I am sick. I'm sick of you not being there for us. We need you. I need you. When was the last time you slept with me? Christ, when was the last time you even touched me? Do you know what that does to me? To know that my own husband is disgusted with me?
Excuse me if I've been too busy working my ass off trying to provide for this family. But no, you're right. It's much more important to whisper sweet nothings in your ear.
You call that work? You lock yourself in there for hours, days. You come out looking like shit, stinking of booze and stale piss.
Thank you.
Oh, that's all right, honey. Something got into Mommy's eye, that's all. You be a good little girl and go to sleep. Daddy's working, so we can't disturb him. Mommy has to go downstairs and take a bath. I love you.
More than a wife, she was first and foremost his muse. Her beauty and talent drove him. After the accident, she became a burden, a disgusting monster screeching out from her bed, an anchor weighing him down.
That dog better not be where I think it is.
Hey there, Princess. You want to sit on Daddy's lap? Come on. It's okay.
All right, young lady. Shall we continue? Right. Whatever happens, just keep looking at me and listen. Now, where was I? Ah, yes. The princess was all alone in the dark. And yet, she felt that the evil witch was lurking nearby. As her eyes adjusted to the darkness, she saw something moving in the corner. And yet, she did not dare to move, for she knew that that would be the end of her. The princess heard a fearsome growl. The witch had unleashed her familiar. The hellhound. The monster sniffed at the air, its perky ears wary of even the slightest sound. The princess remained motionless, letting the monster pass. There was a stillness in the air. The princess breathed a sigh of relief. For a moment, it seemed like the worst was behind her, and yet she knew that it was not over. There was still danger nearby, waiting for her slightest move. Frozen in terror, she kept looking straight ahead. Suddenly, she heard a terrifying cackle. It was the evil witch herself.
Don't you look away!
It was the evil witch herself. The wretched thing despised beauty and innocence, for she had neither. The hag was near, just outside of view, but our heroine didn't dare to look. She had to keep her head straight, lest she be cursed by the witch's foul magic. She could almost feel the chilling touch of the witch's hand at her neck. She felt a sudden urge to run away, but fought it with all her will, for she knew that was precisely what the witch would have wanted. And then, just like that, the chill was gone. She saw a glimmer of light over the horizon. The sun was almost upon her. It was almost dawn. It was almost over. And there! The princess stood triumphant in the sun, smiling as she... Wait. That's not right. Her face. Why is she still... scared? Oh, God. I didn't mean to... Princess, I am so sorry.
It's not that he was cruel. It's just that, to him,
reality was just a pale reflection of art. He was blind to the world, unless it was translated to him through a canvas. Huh. I don't remember that being there.
I can hear you out there. Please, please help me. It hurts. Oh, it hurts so much. I can't take it anymore. Why won't you help me? Oh, you're just like your father. You don't care about me. You probably wish I was dead.
No, that's not how it would.
What is that?
What are you doing? Put that down! You're much too old for that childish nonsense! Creativity is not a toy, it's a gift! Do you want to squander it like all those careless brats out there? I warned you time and time again! I won't let you waste time in these mindless doodles! This is for your own good!
Came upon a crossroads. There she stopped and wondered, which way should I go? Up jumped the wolf and gave the poor girl a fright. Do not be afraid, I'm not gonna bite. One of these paths with danger is fraught, while the other one, most assuredly, is not. The little girl in red took a shortcut she knew, through a lovely field of corn, all covered in dew. But the field grew dark and full of despair. An eerie sense of dread filled the morning air. The girl heard the wolf yelling from afar. You have chosen poorly, you will not get far. Had you only learned how shadow and light intertwined on canvas, you could have chosen right. The little girl in red ran as fast as she could, her flowing dark hair tucked under her hood. But she quickly got tired, worn out by her flight, and succumb to the darkness, never to see the light.
Oh, the summer trees. So green and vibrant and full of life, but also young and inexperienced. Let's try to find them a more poignant season, where they are wiser.
Brilliant! Let's add some more of the same color. That won't make it boring or predictable. Oh, they sway in the breeze, but are none the wiser, just like you. Oh, they sway in the breeze, but are none the wiser, just like you. Ah, yes, the autumn of life, when man seeks shelter from the elements. Let's see how our little hut fares when the skies grow dark. Which part of dark skies did you not understand? No, any old house will do in times of prosperity. We need to see how it fares when misery darkens the sky.
You see? In the end, all we take for granted is fragile and temporary. Man passes, while nature endures. Speaking of which, I don't think our proud stallion likes the weather. Let's brighten things up a bit.
In his own way, I believe he meant well. He wanted me to excel, hoping that when the time came, I would succeed where he failed, avoid his mistakes. God knows he made plenty of those. This place is a mess.
I can hear you in there. I'm coming, you furry little bastards. You're not getting away this time. Oh, where did you put that damn key?
I don't know what I expected to find. A farewell note? A final will? What I found was an apology. Expressed in the only language he ever truly knew. At that moment, I could finally see my father for what he was. A man driven insane with sadness and guilt. Trapped in this house, a nightmarish echo chamber of past mistakes and tragedies. It was this house, a place beyond hope, beyond redemption. I knew what I had to do. I had given up trying to understand my father a long time ago.
finally forgive him.
Hey, Princess. What have you got there? Oh, that's so lovely, sweetie. But why pink?